Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about the block diagram and working of NTSC decoder, that means the NTSC receiver. So let's begin with the topic. NTSC stands for National Television System Committees. The NTSC is basically a standard defined by American companies. NTSC operates on the frequency of 60 Hz. And therefore, it uses 30 frames per second. Each frame contains 525 lines. In case of NTSC, the subcarrier having a fixed frequency having a value of 3.579545 MHz. Because of this constant and having an accurate value and precise value, it is possible to easy recovery of the signal at the receiver. Also, the accurate recovery is also possible because of the precise value of the subcarrier frequency. At the same time, it provides a compatibility between the monochrome and color television standard. The NTSC standard operates very properly when they used in the closed circuit environment. But when they used in the broadcasting environment, they suffer with the problem of color changing. So now, in this topic, we are basically going to talk about the NTSC decoder, that means the receiver circuit. The NTSC transmitter transmits a composite video signal which consists of synchronization pulses, which consist of I and Q signal, which are modulated along with the sound information. Now let's move to the block diagram of NTSC decoder. So here, through the antenna, the signal is get received, which was transmitted by using the NTSC encoder or transmitter. The tune circuit and video IF amplifiers are used along with the video detector and video preamplifier to extract the video information. The sound signals are get extracted at the tuner and video IF amplifier stage, and then by using certain amplification, the signal is then given to the loudspeaker. Now let's move to the description part. So the signals are selected, that means the signal is received from the proper channel through which it was transmitted. The IF and video detector stages are present along with the tuner stage. The sound signal is separately detected and demodulated and amplified before applying it to the loudspeaker, so that the signal strength can be increased to a value which can be easily accessible for the loudspeaker. Now, the first circuit which are used in the NTSC decoder is nothing but the decoding of the chroma signal or decoding of C signal. The chroma signal is available along with other components of the composite signal at the output of the audio preamplifier. So the chrominance signal has color information during active trace time of the picture, and burst occur during blanking time when there is no picture. Therefore, the chrominance signal, or we can say the C signal, and the burst signal, both at 3.58 MHz, they are not present at the same time. That means the chrominance signal is present when during the trace time of the signal, and the burst signal is present during the blanking period. That means both are not present at the same time. Now let's move to the next part, or the next circuit used in the NTSC decoder is nothing but chrominance bandpass amplifier. As its name indicates, it acts as a filter. The purpose of bandpass filter is basically to separate the chrominance signal from the composite video signal, amplify it, and then pass it to the synchronous demodulator. The amplifier has fixed tuning and having a bandpass frequency which is equal to 2 MHz approximately value, and that passes a chroma signal. The blanking pulses are applied to the color killer circuit which turn off chrominance amplifier during this period. Now again, if we move back to the diagram, that is block diagram of NTSC decoder, then we will come to know that. So here, the output of the video preamplifier is further given to the subcarrier color burst separation circuit, which produces the chroma signal and the burst signal, and these two signals are not present at the same time. The chroma signal is present during the trace time and the burst signal is present during the blanking time. Both operate at the frequency of 3.58 MHz. Now the bandpass filter is used, or the bandpass amplifier is used, in order to separate out the chroma signal from the composite video signal. And the bandpass filter having, or the bandpass amplifier having, a frequency of 2 MHz. The bandpass amplifier basically filter out the frequency component, amplify the circuit, amplify the signal, and further given it to the demodulator. Now from the diagram we come to know that the two types of demodulator used over here, one is for the I signal and one is for the Q signal. So the next part of the block diagram is nothing but demodulators. So two demodulators are used. One consists of, one is for the I signal, another is for the Q signal. Synchronous demodulator are basically used for detecting the modulating signal. And such demodulators are provides the signal in the combination of phase and amplitude, because the output is dependent upon both phase and amplitude of the chroma signal. Now let's move back to the block diagram. Now in the block diagram, the signal which is received by the demodulator signal consists of two signals. First is the chroma signal and second is nothing but the constant amplitude signal from the oscillator circuit. So the signal before applying it to the demodulator is get phase shifted. The signal before applying it to the I modulator or I demodulator is get phase shifted by 57 degree. And the signal, that is constant amplitude signal from the local oscillator, before applying it to the synchronous demodulator of Q signal is get phase shifted by 57 degree first and then 90 degree again. That means total phase shift of 147 degree is provided to the Q signal. Because of this phase shift, the Q and I signal are 90 degree phase shifted from each other. Now the output of the filter, or we can say the output of the demodulator, are then frequency restricted by using the two filters. For Q signal, the band filter of 0 to 0.5 MHz is used, and for I signal, the filter of 0 to 1.5 MHz is used. The process is exactly same as what happened in case of transmitter, but here instead of doing modulation, we are dealing with the demodulation, which is exactly opposite than the NTSC encoder. Now let's move to the next block, which is present in the NTSC decoder, and this block is next is nothing but the color matrix. The function of color matrix is to provide the different color signal. A suitable color matrix is used so that a different color signals can be generated. So the basically the color matrix are used for providing a signal which consists of R minus Y, G minus Y and B minus Y signal from I and Q video signal, where Y is a luminance signal and RGB stands for the primary color, that is red, green and blue. The color difference signal amplifier are required to perform two functions. First of all, as its name indicates, it amplifies the signal and compensate the chroma signal compression that was introduced at the time of transmission of the signal by doing a preventive overmodulation. So because of the overmodulation of the signal may get compressed. So to avoid that, the matrix is required to be selected in the proper way. The next block or the next circuit which are used in the NTSC decoder is nothing but the bus separator. So the bus separator circuit having a function of extracting 8 to 11 cycles of the reference color burst, which are transmitted on the back porch of every horizontal sync pulse. The horizontal sync pulse are basically added after each line scan. Now the circuit is tuned to the subcarrier frequency, that is nothing but 3.8 or 3.579545 MHz. The burst output is further given to the phase discrimination circuit, which is also known as automatic frequency and phase control circuit. Now next is nothing but the color subcarrier oscillator. The function of the color subcarrier oscillator is to generate a sinusoidal wave or the carrier signal having a frequency of 3.579545 MHz. Now the value is precise so that it provides a compatibility between the monochrome and color system. The subcarrier frequency mentioned is a correct value by the AFTC circuit. The next type of circuit which is present in the NTSC decoder is nothing but the color killer circuit. As its name indicates, the circuit becomes on and it disables the chroma signal. And that means the chroma bandpass amplifier during the monochrome reception. That means there will be no color information get displayed on the screen. This is prevent any signal which happens to fall within a bandpass of the chroma amplifier. And when it is get off, then when the killer circuit is get off, the chroma bandpass signal gets on and the colorful information get displayed on the screen. Therefore, basically it performs a function of color killing. As its name indicates, if it is on, then it avoids any color information to pass further and extract and receive only monochrome information. Whereas when the circuit is off, then the colorful information get displayed on the screen. The next type of circuit which is present in the NTSC decoder is nothing but manual color control. The two additional color controls are required in case of NTSC color receiver, and they are nothing but the saturation level control and tint or hue control. the value of U is different for different colors, and they are basically used for distinguishing between the color. If we consider the red tomatoes, then the red tomatoes having red hue in that. Now, moving towards the second parameter, that is nothing but the saturation level, it indicates the purity of the color. That means how much percentage of white color present in that particular color. For example, if we take vivid green color, then it is purely saturated color because it has no white component. So basically, the saturation provides the amount of white component present in the color. If we add white color into the vivid green color, the color turns to the light green color. That means the color get unsaturated. So this is how the hue and the saturation color provides chromaticity, or we can say the colorfulness or chroma of the signal. So these two controls are required to be provided by the manual control circuit. So these are the various circuits which are present in NTSC decoder. So now let's move back to the circuit diagram or the block diagram. So at the end, let's summarize the working or construction of the NTSC decoder. The signal is received from the transmitter by using a suitable channel through antenna. Then the signal is further given to the tuner and video IF amplifier. Here only the sound signal is get separated, and through amplification and further processing, the signal is given to the loudspeaker. Further, the video signal is given to the video detector and video amplifier. Demodulator receives two input. One is the constant amplitude signal from the oscillator, and other is nothing but the chroma signal. The constant amplitude oscillator signal is phase shifted first by 57 degree, and then it is applied to the synchronous demodulator related to I signal, and it is again get shifted by 90 degree and then applied to the Q demodulator. Therefore, the Q demodulator having total phase shift of 147 degree. Further, the signal is frequency restricted by using 0.5 MHz filter for Q signal and 0 to 1.5 MHz signal for I signal. Now the matrix is present, which is responsible for producing the different or suitable color at the output. Therefore, here in case of decoder, the matrix produces three different signals, and the signals are R minus Y, G minus Y, B minus Y. Whereas in case of transmitter, the function of matrix is to produce Y signal, that is luminance signal, I signal and Q signal on receiving the RGB input. Now here, the color killer circuit is also present, which is basically used for killing the color. That means when it is on, it blocks the operation, or we can say it stops the operation of bandpass color bandpass amplifier. Therefore, it can receive only monochrome information, that is black and white information. And if it is get off, then the color information is get displayed on the screen. Then the next type of circuit which is present in the NTSC decoder is nothing but the automatic frequency as phase control circuit. The subcarrier control circuit or the subcarrier generator circuits are used over here for generating the subcarrier, so that we can have the accurate reproduction of the signal at the receiver, and we can have a compatibility between the transmitter and receiver, as well as between the color and monochrome system. Now, the next is nothing but the video amplifier, which is basically used for increasing the strength of the signal so that it can drive the further system. So this is what about the NTSC decoder, or we can say NTSC receiver, which are used in the color television and operates on the frequency of 60 Hz. So I hope you understand the topic of NTSC decoder. So thank you very much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikira. Subscribe Ikira. Thank you.